announced it's showtime, and each week at this same hour, Showtime brings you a specially adapted version of one of the most popular musicals produced on Broadway or in Hollywood. This week, Showtime presents the delightful Victor Herbert operetta, Naughty Marietta, starring Gordon McRae as Dick Warrington and Nadine Connor as Marietta. Our choir is under the direction of Norman Luboff, the music arranged and conducted by Carmen Dragon. And now, here is the curtain on Victor Herbert's Naughty Marietta.
Naughty Marietta, you will hear the lovely Metropolitan Opera soprano, Nadine Connor. And I play the role of Captain Dick Warrington, whose band of soldiers fought for country and for honor in New Orleans in the year 1780. And of an unfinished melody.
until you find the man who can sing the other half of that melody you heard in your dream.
Oh, but where will I find the man who will complete the melody?
A ship of brides sails on the morrow for New Orleans. Forget that you are an Italian noblewoman. Go down to that ship and pay one of the girls to give you her place on the bride ship. Somewhere across the world, you will find the man you seek. But guard your identity. Let no one know who you are.
I will go. I'll do it.
So Marietta took her place on the bride ship and sailed for New Orleans. On the day the ship landed, my men and I marched into town to see the governor and tell him that we had received orders from the King of France to capture a pirate who was terrifying the city. A pirate named Bras Pete. We were in good spirits at the prospect of an adventure, and we marched into town singing. Tramp, tramp, tramp along the highway. Tramp, 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 the road is free. Blazing trails along the byway. Captain Dixon Infantry. Captain Dixon Infantry.
Tramp, tramp, tramp along the highway. Tramp, 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 the road is free. Blazing trails along the byway. River, hurry.
Tramp, 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 now clear the roadway. Room, 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 the world. I dismissed my men so they could go down and have a look at the bride ship. And as I turned to leave the square, I heard someone singing. I looked back and saw for the first time Marietta. She had perched herself on the edge of the fountain, as though she had every right in the world to be there. Just a minute, young lady.
Yes, monsieur?
You're one of the girls from the bride ship, aren't you?
I may be, and then, on the other hand, I may not.
Well, you have no business in the square. You'd be down on the ship letting some man choose you for a wife.
Are you coming down to the bride ship?
Me? I should say not. I value my freedom too much.
Well, so do I. That's why I'm here and not there. I have run away. Oh, please help me.
Help?
Help me.
I'm going to take you right to the governor and turn you over to him. You had no right to take a place in the ship under false pretenses.
Monsieur, if I stayed at home in Italy, they were going to marry me to a fat old man with a beard down to his knees. And if you turn me over to the governor, then that will be my fate. And I will kill myself.
Well, you're quite a little spitfire, aren't you?
I may be, monsieur. And then, again, I may not.
There are two little maidens that live in my heart. And one is so good, my dear. She loves me so. La la, like water would melt my skin. But the other little maiden that holds so
you're Naughty Marietta. Now, what am I going to do with you? Well, look ahead there. My friend Rudolfo, who runs the Marionette Theater.
Rudolfo!
Capitano Warrington! Oh, it's good to see you back again.
Well, Rudolfo. How are things with you?
Oh, business is slow, Capitan Warrington. Since my son left me, I got to know singers. How am I to draw crowds to my marionette show without the singers?
Jemima, I am a singer. Oh, please, I beg of you. The old man's beard is below his knees. It's almost down to his ankles.
Well, I shall probably regret this the rest of my life. Rudolfo, this girl is a singer. Would you take care of her for a while as a favor to me?
Would you sing, signorina?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I would like to hear you.
All right. Can your troupe play the Italian street song?
Of course we can play it. Uno momento, I give you introduce. One, two, go! My daughter, Signor Etienne.
You should not have kept her hidden so long. She's very beautiful. Ah, good day, Captain Warrington.
Good day, Etienne.
You might advise your men, Captain. The governor has just received a communication from the King of France offering 10,000 francs for the return of Marietta, Countess Calcena, who disguised herself as a casket girl and ran away. I'm going down to the bride ship now and look for her.
Is that so?
Rudolfo, if you don't mind, I shall be calling on your lovely daughter later.
Goodbye, monsieur.
Rudolfo, take the girl away before there's more trouble.
Si. Come, signorina.
Goodbye, Marietta.
Au revoir, monsieur. Oh, monsieur, just a moment.
Yes?
That song, where did you hear it?
Why, I heard you singing it just a little while ago.
Oh, sing it for me, monsieur, please.
Oh, I don't even know it.
Please, Captain Warrington. It means everything in the world to me.
Well, if it's that important.
Oh, it is.
I'll do my best.
Oh, sweet mystery of life, in vain I seek thee. Oh, at last to know the secret of it all.
Sorry, Marietta, I haven't the least idea how to finish it.
I'm sorry too, monsieur. I hope desperately that you would.
Marietta is the story of a girl and of an unfinished melody. I kept telling myself the girl was no concern of mine and tried to convince myself that the only reason I kept going to see Rudolfo's marionette show was to be sure she wasn't being any trouble to Rudolfo. But as time passed, I found myself dreaming of Marietta more and more. And at night, I'd walk along the levee in the moonlight with the old New Orleans love songs whispering in my ears. Had been with Rudolfo several weeks when the gayest event of the New Orleans social season took place, the masquerade ball. I wanted to take Marietta, but she had already promised to go with Etienne. However, at the ball, I did have a dance with her. Well, you're looking very beautiful tonight, Marietta.
Thank you, Captain Warrington. I was told you had eyes for no one's beauty except Monsieur Etienne's beautiful slave girl, Ada.
Who told you that, Etienne?
What does it matter? Who told me? Well, you seem different tonight. What's wrong with you, Captain Warrington?
Perhaps the same thing that's wrong with you, Mademoiselle.
Yes, perhaps.
I have a very strange feeling I never felt before. A kind of a grind of depression.
My heart's acting strangely. It feels rather sore. At least it gives me the impression.
My pulse has leaped madly. Without any cause. Believe me, I'm telling
then you do love someone.
Yes, Dick. It's true.
Listen! Hear yours! Hear yours! According to the long-established custom of the Quadroon Ball, any man who wishes to buy, sell, or exchange his favorite slave may take advantage of the cordon bleu. Come! Come, who will buy, sell, or exchange? Is no one here brave enough? Well, then, I will open the sale with the most beautiful slave in New Orleans. Anda!
$500,
my friend. I've bid $500 for the most beautiful slave in New Orleans.
$1,000.
Captain Warrington.
$1,000. Come, that is better. $1,000.
$500.
$1,500.
$1,800.
$2,000. Come. Come, I gave him proof. $2,000 is bid for La Ballada.
Captain Warrington, if you bid again, I shall never speak to you as long as I live.
I can't let Adrian sell her to that man.
$2,200.
$2,200. I bid $2,200. Going.
$3,000.
$3,000. Sword to Captain Richard Warrington for $3,000. Captain Richard Warrington, who does not believe in slaves, has purchased for himself the most beautiful girl in New Orleans.
You are to be complimented, monsieur. Ada is indeed beautiful. Monsieur Etienne. Monsieur Etienne.
Yes, Marietta.
You asked for my hand when you thought I was only Marietta, the daughter of Rudolfo. Now I confess to you that I am the Contessa Marietta d'Altena, and I tell you that I will be happy to be your wife.
Marietta.
Mademoiselle, you've made me the happiest man in New Orleans. Come, we shall be wed tonight.
Whatever you wish, monsieur. My master.
I am not your master, Ada. I bought you to set you free.
Free? I, a free woman? Then I will act like one. Monsieur, would you prevent this wedding?
Yes, but how can I?
On Etienne's right arm, you will find his name.
His name?
Bras-Pique. Bras-Pique the pirate.
Bras-Pique. Thank you, Ada. You've repaid me 1,000 times over.
Who is it? Oh, Rodolfo. I didn't know you were here at the ball.
I just came now when I heard what had happened. Marietta, you are making a big mistake.
Why do you say that, Rodolfo?
Captain Dick has set Ada free. That's the only reason he bought her, so he could give her freedom. He loves you.
No. No, he doesn't love me, Rodolfo. I used to hope that he would. But I have known for some time that it is quite hopeless. I am going to marry Etienne.
Oh, in any case, you cannot marry Etienne. He's already in jail.
In jail? What do you mean?
He's the pirate, Bras-Pique.
No.
Capitana Dick and his men captured him a little while ago.
Dick captured him?
Si. Oh, be kind to him, Marietta. He does love you. Listen.
It's my melody. He knows its meaning. He knows.
Darling, my heart taught me to finish to your song. Will you marry me now?
I must marry you. For it was foretold that when I found a man who could complete my song, I would find happiness and fulfill my destiny. Here will I stay and love you always.